Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a powerfully compelling poster with gradient text, a beautifully effected photo, and body copy that wraps around your subject. Open a photo of someone that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. Before we begin, I want to mention that I'll be moving a bit quicker for more advanced users. The first step is to separate the subject from its background by making a selection around your subject. For this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool, which I covered how to use in many of my tutorials. Refine your selection by using the Select and Mask filter or the Refine Edge filter, depending on which Photoshop version you're using. I did in-depth tutorials on both filters, so if you'd like to watch them, I provided their links in my video's description below. Output it to a new layer with Layer Mask. We'll convert it into a smart object, which will allow us to modify or adjust the filters that we'll be adding to the image. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Make a new layer below it by Control-clicking or Command-clicking the New Layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with black, but first, if your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since black is your foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill the empty layer with black. Make the top layer active and click the Adjustment Layer icon. Click Hue Saturation and check Colorize. For the hue, I'll type in 209, the saturation 53, and for lightness, I'll keep it at 0. Feel free to adjust these settings for your image. Make your image active and go to Filter and Filter Gallery. If you want to see more of your image, press Control or Command and the minus key on your keyboard. Open the Distort folder and click Diffuse Glow. I'll keep the graininess 0, the glow amount 2, and the clear amount 10, but again, feel free to adjust these amounts. Click the FX icon and click Outer Glow. The color is white, the blend mode is normal, and the opacity is 100%. The technique is softer, and the spread is 0. For this image, I made the size 20 pixels. However, you may want to adjust the size amount depending on the size and resolution of your document. Click Inner Glow. The color is white, the blend mode is color dodge, and the opacity is 50%. The technique is softer, and the source is edge. I'll make the choke 10% and the size 250 pixels, but again, you may want to adjust these amounts. To save space in the Layers panel, let's collapse the effects. We're ready to add our main text. Open your horizontal type tool. We'll make our text temporarily white so we can see it over the background. To do this, invert the foreground and background colors by clicking this icon or by pressing X on your keyboard. Pick a font. I'm using Bank Gothic Bold. If you'd like to use it as well, I provided its link in my video's description or project files below. make its size temporarily 100 points so it's large enough to see. Click the center alignment icon. Click on your document and type out your text. We want to ultimately increase its size to near the edges of our poster. To do this, click your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it out. Then press Enter or Return. To center it over the document, press Ctrl or Command A to select our canvas and click the Align Horizontal Centers icon. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. Go to View and make sure Rulers and Snap are checked. If they aren't, just click on them. Go to the left ruler and drag out a guideline until it snaps to the left edge of your text. If you don't see the guideline, press Ctrl or Command H. Go back to the ruler and drag out another guideline to the right edge of your text. Scroll to the top of the Layers panel and drag your text layer to the top. Click the FX icon and click Gradient Overlay. Click the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. Click the black-white preset and the lower left stop. Click the color box to open the color picker. Pick a color for the bottom of your gradient text. Since I already know the color I want, I'll type it into the hexadecimal field. 1, 2, D, 0, FF. Once you pick your color, to accept it, press Enter or Return 3 times to close all 3 windows. Make a copy of the text by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Go to the text and press and hold Shift as you drag the copy straight down. Press T to open your type tool and highlight your text. If your new line of text has more characters than it has now, go to the T icon at the top and drag your cursor to the left. Now, type out your text. To increase its size, click your Move tool and open your Transform tool to increase its size to the guidelines. To move your text 1 pixel at a time, press the left or right arrow key on your keyboard. Once your text is lined up with the guidelines, press Enter or Return to accept it. Use your up or down arrow key on your keyboard to slide your text up or down equidistant to the bottom of your document as your other text is to the top of your document. Scroll to the bottom and make the black layer active. Above it, we're going to place another line of text which will appear behind our subject and our other lines of text. Open your horizontal type tool again and click on the background. For this text, I'll use Dense Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. I'll increase its size and type out my text. Since I'm going to ultimately increase its size to the edges of my poster, I'll zoom out of my document by pressing Ctrl or Command plus the minus key on my keyboard. Open your Move tool and drag your text to the center. Open your Transform tool and increase your text to the edges of your poster. Before we give this text some color, we first need to clip our subject's adjustment layer to just the subject, otherwise the adjustment layer will affect all the layers below it, including this text. We'll make the hue saturation adjustment layer into a clipping mask by first making it active and pressing Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. Now, the adjustment layer is affecting only our subject and no other layers. Double-click your bottom text to highlight it. At the top, click the color box to open the color picker and pick a color for your background text. I'll type in 00498C. Open your Move tool. To fit your document back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. To make our bottom and top text pop more, we'll add soft black gradients behind them. To do this, make the adjustment layer active and click the new layer icon to make a new layer above it. We want the foreground color to be black, so press X on your keyboard to invert your colors. Open your gradient tool and make sure your linear gradient icon is active. Click the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. Click the foreground to transparent preset and click OK. Go to the top of your poster and press and hold Shift as you drag the gradient tool to approximately here. Go to the bottom and repeat the process as you drag the tool up. Next, we'll add text that wraps around the outside of our subject. Control-click or Command-click the thumbnail of our subject to make a selection of its shape. Go to Select, Modify, and Expand. I'll expand it 20 pixels, but you may want to adjust this amount based on your document size and resolution. Invert your selection by pressing Control or Command-Shift-I. Open your rectangular marquee tool and place your cursor on the left guideline below your top text. Press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag your tool to the lower right guideline above your text. Then, release. Your selection now should look similar to mine. Open your Paths panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Paths. Open the flyout list and click Make Work Path. Keep the default tolerance of 0.5 pixels. Then, save the path and click OK. Before we add the text that will wrap around the outside of our subject, we need to temporarily hide the large text behind our subject to avoid activating the large text when we click on our document. Open back the Layers panel. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer and scroll down to your large text. Click the eyeball icon to hide the text and scroll back up to the empty layer you just made. Open your Type tool again and invert your foreground and background colors. I'll pick Bank Gothic Bold. Once you pick your font, click this icon, which opens the character and paragraph panels. I'll make its size 16 points and the leading 15 points. Leading is the space between lines of text. You can change these amounts later if you like. Open the paragraph panel and click the left aligned text icon. Hide the guidelines by pressing Ctrl or Command H. We're ready to add paragraphs of text to the left of our subject. Click inside the path. There are three ways you can add text inside a work path. One way is to actually type your text inside the path. Another way is to copy and paste text from an outside source. And the third way is to paste in or generate Lorem Ipsum. This is essentially filler text, also known as dummy text. It's meant to serve as a placeholder for the actual text that you'll ultimately use. Version CS6 and later already comes with its own Lorem Ipsum generator. However, if you're using an earlier version, I included a few links of free online Lorem Ipsum generators. If you're using CS6 or later, go to Type and paste Lorem Ipsum. Automatically, it pastes in the font, size, leading, and alignment you chose. When we click on Right Align Text, our text justifies to the right edge of our path. I'll click back on Left Align Text, however, feel free to experiment with the alignments. Click your Move tool and open back your Paths panel. Click the thumbnail of Path 1 and open back your Type tool. Click inside the right path. I'll click the Right Align Text icon and go back to Type and paste Lorem Ipsum. Click your Move tool and close the Character and Paragraph panels. Open back your Layers panel, scroll to the large text, and make it visible. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.